What's up, Falcons Nation? It's your boy, Ju, coming at you with another Atlanta Falcons video. As always, Falcons Nation, rise up. In today's video, I want to give you guys some quick Atlanta Falcons news. But if you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Hit that notification bell so you'll know when I've done Atlanta Falcons content. Hit that like button for your boy. I do appreciate each and every one of you guys continuing to tune into the channel. Continuing to share out my content on all the social media platforms. If you would like to follow your boy on Twitter and Instagram, you can follow me at JuTalkSports. If you would like to donate to my channel, you can donate to my Cash App, which is the $ JuTalkSports. But I do appreciate each and every one of you guys continuing to support the channel. We are currently on the road to 2,000 subscribers, so definitely continue to share out this content. But with that being said, let's jump right into the video. So first off, in Atlanta Falcons news, today, Jonathan Bullard, defensive end slash defensive tackle for Atlanta Falcons, did return to practice. He's missed the last three games due to an ankle injury. So it's definitely good to get back Jonathan Bullard. He's definitely a solid rotational piece as the as a 3-4 defensive end. He's done a pretty good job this year. I believe he has one sack on the season. But he's played pretty well when he's been out there for Atlanta Falcons, setting the edge in the run game especially. So it's definitely going to be good to get back Jonathan Bullard in the rotation possibly this coming Sunday against Carolina. They haven't said whether he will play on Sunday against Carolina, but he did return to practice today from that ankle injury. Also in Atlanta Falcons news, Hayden Hurst, our tight end, has returned to practice as well. He's back from an ankle injury himself. He's missed the last three games for Atlanta Falcons due to that ankle injury. He was brought off of IR, and he did practice today and is trending upward where he possibly can play Sunday against Carolina. They haven't stated whether he was whether or not he will play either on Sunday, but there's a good chance he could be back with our team this coming Sunday at that tight end position, which bodes well for guys like Matt Ryan. And bodes well for the offense of our Atlanta Falcons. It gives us another weapon that Matt Ryan can rely on in the passing game. So definitely good to get back Hayden Hurst. Also on the injury report today, Cordarrelle Patterson, he's not injured, but he did have a rest day today. So shout outs to Cordarrelle Patterson, who's definitely been an X factor for our team so far this year. And they're definitely resting him as he has been battling an ankle injury as well, but he has played the last two games for our Atlanta Falcons, and he's played well. Also, in Atlanta Falcons news today, as far as injury report, Ade Ogundeji, who's our defensive end slash outside linebacker, the rookie out of Notre Dame, he has also is recovering from an ankle injury. He was on the injury report today. And he hasn't practiced all week due to an ankle injury. He got injured on Sunday, and he's been out all week. So it looks like he may not be able to play on Sunday against Carolina due to his ankle injury. And also, rookie safety slash nickel corner, Richie Grant, he's also battling an ankle injury, and he didn't practice today as well. And he's missed practice all week as well due to an ankle injury. So we are kind of down with a lot of guys with these ankle injuries. I don't expect Ogundeji or Richie Grant to play Sunday due to the ankle injuries, but we're going to keep playing it by ear closer to game time on Sunday against Carolina. But it doesn't sound like Richie Grant or Ade Ogundeji will be able to play, being that they haven't practiced all week. Also in Atlanta Falcons news, the last player on the injury report was Kendall Sheffield. Kendall Sheffield is the corner for our team. He's been with our team for about 2 to 3 years now out of Ohio State. He's a speedster at that corner position, and he is returning from a hamstring injury. So he's back with the team, and he possibly could play on Sunday. And also in that injury report as well is Fabian Monroe, who is our starting corner, outside corner, opposite of A.J. Terrell. He is actually battling a hamstring injury, and he may miss Sunday's game as well against the Panthers. So it's going to be very interesting to see who fills in at that outside corner position if Fabian Monroe is unable to go on Sunday, I could see a guy like a Kendall Sheffield. I could possibly see guys like Darren Hall. We have a lot of young corners on this team, but I think Kendall Sheffield possibly would be the most experienced guy that you can put out there opposite of AJ Terrell at that corner position. If Fabian Monroe is not able to play on Sunday, but it's going to be real interesting to see who fills in at that other corner position on the outside, being that it looks like Fabian Monroe may not be able to go. If it was me, I would put Kendall Sheffield on that outside corner role and leave Darren Hall in the slot and use those guys, you know, let it play out that way. But it's going to be very interesting to see on Sunday because we're kind of nicked up on the defensive side of the ball, nicked up in the secondary. It's going to be very interesting to see which guys are able to go on Sunday. But with that being said, that's pretty much all I have for the injury report and Atlanta Falcons news. Also today, the Atlanta Falcons did bring back tight end Parker Hess. We added him to the practice squad. He was a guy that got released early this week when we added Hayden Hurst back to the active roster. And they basically released Parker Hess, who was a backup tight end for our team. He's like our third or fourth string tight end. They did bring him back and add him back to the practice squad. But that's pretty much all I had for Atlanta Falcons news. But I do appreciate each and every one of you guys tuning in. Definitely hit that like button, hit that subscribe button for your boy. Also go over to Atlanta Falcons Nation as well. Make sure you guys hit that like and subscribe button there for us as well, as we're also on the road to 2,000 subscribers there. But with that being said, this be your boy, Jew. I have a lot more content coming for you guys as always. But as always, Falcons Nation, rise up. Peace.